Hi everyone, welcome to today's Verify API webinar, Fight Fraudsters with Two-Factor Authentication. I'm Elaine, Regional Marketing Manager at Vonage and also your host for today. So before we begin, I have a few housekeeping items for you. You may choose to either type your questions in the questions tab or raise your hand. And if you do raise your hand, I will bring you up to the foreground where you appear on screen with our panels to ask them your question. So please allow your camera and microphone permission. After asking a question, you will then be toggled off screen. Also, please note that we will not be answering pricing questions in today's webinar. Kindly redirect your pricing questions to sea.marketing@vonage.com. I am very happy and proud to say that today's session is hosted on our very own Vonage Video API. But today we're going to talk about the Verify API. So let's have a look at the agenda, what we're going to cover today. We're going to take a quick look at authentication and discuss some of the problems and solutions that businesses face, how 2FA works and its benefits before we turn the spotlight onto our customer speaker from Carousel. And lastly, we've got some exciting news to share with our audiences today about Verify 2.0. I'm very pleased to have three people on the panel today. They are Ketan Mujumdar, Director of Engineering at Carousel, Sarah Mendoza, Product Marketing Manager at Vonage, Guillermo Quintero, Senior Product Manager at Vonage. All right, let's get rock and rolling. Now over to you.
Awesome. Thank you. Hi, everybody. My name is Sarah. As Elaine mentioned, it's lovely to be here with you folks. Good morning to you. And it's evening time for me here in the U.S. But yes, just a bit of intro here. If you could flip to the next slide for me, Guillermo, just to set the table here for why we do what we do at Vonage. And our vision, it's really centered on our mission to accelerate the world's ability to connect, right? And how we do that is by enabling businesses to take advantage of our next generation communication APIs that are flexible and they're easy to embed into our brand's existing systems. We're going to get into that today. And you'll find that our communications are intelligent and they truly allow you to implement a custom and personal approach for building your platforms. And that customization part, it's really important. Because how your specific customers experience your products and services differently than your competition, that really is going to be the key differentiator, right? And Vonage allows you to build that unique experience. You can't simply compete in the market by price alone today and what you're charging. And it's not even necessarily the product and features you're offering alone either, since more and more brands and providers are entering the market and you're having to compete against that constantly, right? So that's why the opportunity to provide that customer experience that is efficient, that's effective, and that is custom built for your specific customer and your audience is extremely important. And the Vonage APIs really do help you get there. All right, so now on the next slide here, let's talk about how so much of that customer experience, it really does involve how we enable businesses like yours to attract, onboard and engage with customers. And verifying your customers is really the first step in that customer journey, right? It's being able to validate them and onboard them. That is the first thing that needs to happen to acquire new customers and to expand your database and really your reach, right? Because before a business ever sends their first message to communicate with their audience about important alerts or service them with their important needs over email or SMS or voice or whatever channel that might be for that matter, you really first need to gain their trust, right? And successfully onboard them onto your program through secure authentication. All right, next slide, Guillermo. Verification is especially interesting also when we look at how communications has changed. And it really has within our communities across our country, across the globe. And it's really caused businesses like yours to need to pivot with that as well. And if you're not, you're really falling behind. We know how everyone is connected to so many smart devices today. And therefore, our customers' needs look different, right? So what does the typical customer or end user look like? Well, they seek the convenience of a digital and connected experience, right? And that's across all of their devices, their cell phone, their laptop, their tablet, and all of the applications that they use, which are downloaded on all of those devices. And folks really love that ability to communicate easily. And as they jump on, you know, to their cell phone, and they want to be able to do that. And hey, they're certainly using various mediums all at once at all times. And that's not only your cell phone, but it's also through voice, it's through texting, it's through your social chat apps, it's through email, and they're communicating on these different channels for different types of situations. Now, with all of these channels, there is also a hurdle that has been brought to the forefront. Mitigate this, right? And that's that people have unfortunately become much more exposed being present on all of these various channels. So we're seeing fraudsters out there get smarter, unfortunately, and they're taking advantage of those non-secure exposures. And in fact, we're seeing that online fraud is increasing by more than 30%, which can be extremely costly for your business. So let's talk a little bit more about those challenges on the next slide here. Now, Vonage has been very mindful of the new communication standards and these challenges that come along with it, right? And we've realized as an organization how important it is to connect to the right customer and to offer a program that is secure and protects them, the customer, the end customer, as well as businesses like yours. So let's talk about that. There can be serious consequences, right? If you're authenticating your audience first here, businesses are faced with bogus customers and end users. And those are coming from fraudulent accounts or bots. So businesses are really wasting their energy, right, on those fraudulent accounts. And they're risking their program, which is, you know, on the wrong audience there. Secondly, hacking. Hacking continues to be a risk that needs to be managed by businesses because when accounts are compromised, this can cause a breach in the real account holder's data, which is going to frustrate that customer and ruin that overall customer experience and can even cause that customer to bounce or churn, right? And another challenge is the fact that with so many channels and ways for communication, it's hard for businesses like yours to really know which is the best way to reach your diverse audience, right? So there are three challenges that we're seeing. Next slide, please, Guillermo. Now, all of that is exacerbated further when companies have a global audience, right? So we need to take that into consideration. We've got language barriers becoming an issue with authentication on the voice and SMS channels, for example. Businesses have to face non-action on authentication requests due to this, and therefore multiple tries are needed. Also, where you are in the world also means you have different preferences for communicating and certainly in the authentication stage. For example, Japan prefers voice authentication as a security measure, whereas here in the US, we see the SMS channel perhaps being a more natural choice. And on top of that, each country has different compliance guidelines for program security and connectivity varies and may be a problem for one country more than the other, causing SMS or voice to not be as effective in certain areas. All right, anything you wanna add here, Guillermo, before I moved on to the next challenge point? I know this was...
No, I know, I think you covered it well.
Okay, awesome. All right, moving on to the next challenge I want to tackle here. Now, when you can't authenticate your audience and build that trust with them, while also, of course, building your platform integrity, that's also going to impact your business dollars, right? When you can't properly onboard and convert your users, your customers, this is impacting your revenue that you would be making from them. And furthermore, it's extremely costly. In fact, as you can see here, the global average cost of a data breach 6.4% in 2020 over the previous year, and that was up to almost 3.9 million. So that's a lot of money. All right, now, what are we gonna do about this? So next slide. With all of this in mind, Vonage has prioritized our authentication capabilities. And we continue to expand and add to our features and tools that help a business properly authenticate and build that secure platform and program. So here is our Vonage Verify solution. With all of those complexities that we just talked about, Verify truly simplifies all of it for you, right? With the ability to validate users by sending a one-time password or OTP, one that's pre-built and full service. So it really solves the need for secure customer acquisition over channel makes the best sense for your customer, whether that's SMS or voice. And hey, we also have channels being new channels being launched as well, which we'll get to in a bit. Now, as an important tool, Verify includes retry sequences and failover options that ensures a business will get in touch with their customer effectively. Also, if the business wants more control over their program, it is extremely flexible. You can bring your own PIN and set the authentication workflows. And it does come in various languages and templates. I know many of you are communicating across different countries. So you do have that capability as well, as we service many global companies. So in short, Verify does all of the heavy lifting for our businesses in this crucial step of verification. Before I pass it to how it works with Guillermo, I just want to make a point additional benefits here on the next slide, I think. There you go. Thank you. Yeah, so just some more benefits to mention. We've been talking about this, but you really do need to know that customer acquisition, hey, it's the name of the game here. And Verify can really drive that for your business with high deliverability that's supported by seamless failover between our expanding channels like SMS and voice, and more to come, which we'll tell you about. And again, for our global companies, Verify validates phone numbers on a global scale and takes care of troubleshooting any compliance regulations and requirements that need to be addressed in the countries you're communicating in. And this last point is really the game changer for our business customers, right? Because with all of these different guidelines, complexities that comes with managing the authentication program, we really have simplified that for you. You don't need any telco or verification expertise. Our technology and our team here, we truly support you with building that program to properly authenticate your customers, your users across the globe. And even if your customers are giving us the number, or you, the business, are giving us the numbers, we can take care of everything for you, which helps a great deal. All right, now I am going to pass it to Guillermo to share with us how exactly this works.
Thanks, Sarah, and apologize earlier for slipping and going through a couple of slides. My mouse has a mind of its own today. So hi, everybody. My name is Guillermo. I'm the product manager for Verify. I'm just going to talk a little bit briefly about how the API works. And then I'm really excited to and grateful to have Ketan on from Carousel, one of our Verify customers, who will talk a little bit more about how they use the product. And then we'll wrap up with an announcement, and then we'll end with Q&A. So, apologize for the dogs barking. I'm in my garage. Apologize for the background and for any noise. Working in COVID, this is kind of the situation that we're in. So bear with me. Okay, so the Verify API. So what we like to say about Verify is that it's as simple as sending an SMS. So if you ever sent an SMS using an API, you just have to specify the phone number and the number it's coming from, and then of course the message, of course, and then you send it off. Well, actually, using Verify, this tagline should actually be that it's more simple than sending an SMS. What we've done is we've kind of abstracted the complexities around not only PIN code generation, failover management, and channels, but also stabilize the entire infrastructure across the world so that you can scale across the world. And that results in basically you being able to, as a customer or a potential customer, being able to authenticate a phone number with actually less parameters than you would need for actually sending an SMS. So the way that the API works is you put in the phone number that you want to authenticate, that you want to two-factor authenticate. And you send it to our platform. And then we will go ahead and generate the PIN code and select the channel. And what you see in the screenshot here is actually exactly what you'll see for a template when you're using Verify. So app code would be your brand, or it could be Acme, or it could be Carousel, whatever that may be. And then the PIN code that we've generated, and then how long it's valid for. So the end user, of course, would then see that PIN code come in through an SMS if it is going through SMS, the SMS channel. And like I mentioned before, we would retry and fail over to another SMS channel or to the TTS channel, which is voice, to deliver that PIN code if need be. The end user receives the PIN code. They enter the PIN code into your application. And then what you do is just, I'll cover this in a subsequent slide here, but you do one more API call to just check that the PIN code that the end user entered is the PIN code that we in fact generated. So there are a couple of newer features. We've actually had these out for quite a while, but a couple of newer features that we've integrated or recently shipped with the API. So there is now the ability to generate and bring your own PIN to the Verify API experience should you choose, meaning you don't have to rely on the PIN code that we generate. Right now we default either to 4 or 6 digits. Pretty soon we're gonna be expanding that to up to 10 digits, and we'll have the option for alphanumeric, but currently it's 4 to 6. But anyway, you can specify if you have your own PIN code management system, you can generate your own PIN and send it through the Verify API just through a separate parameter. And then the other relatively new feature is the ability to customize the workflows. So maybe you want to start with, maybe you know your end users and you know what they prefer in the country that they are in, and you would prefer to not use TTS at all, use voice at all. You could opt for just 2 SMS attempts, for example, or you could do the inverse. You could just only use TTS, for example. So it allows you as the customer to have flexibility with the API as a separate parameter to specify and tell us what workflow you would like to use. And then, so as I mentioned in 2 slides ago, the check happens with, like I said, a separate, what we call a Verify check call in the instance that you are using our PIN code, because of course you would need to know what PIN code is generated, and you would want to kind of match that against what the end user is putting into your application so that you could successfully authenticate them and move on to doing and allowing your end user to do whatever it is that they would prefer to do, probably get into your application and explore the services that you offer. So I just wanted to put this in here because it is one simple API call with the phone number that you want to authenticate. We handle all the heavy lifting in terms of sender ID, in terms of channel selection, failover, and PIN code generation. And then once that PIN code is entered, you do one more check, one more API call to check that it is the correct PIN. Okay, so one last slide, and then we'll get into kind of the customer experience with Ketan and Carousel, which I'm very excited for. So 2 Verify models that we have at the moment. We actually have 3, but we'll only talk about 2 today. And if you're interested in kind of the third, we can certainly discuss that. There's Verify Conversion, what we call Verify Conversion. This is the version that we generate the PIN code. We have a version called Verify Request, which is where you generate and bring your own PIN code to the Verify experience. That's the only difference other than price. Because you as a customer are doing a little bit more work on your end, it's a little bit cheaper. So that's why there's a small price difference. You're only paying for successful conversions on the Verify conversion model. You're only paying for successful conversions plus the SMS and TTS attempts that you choose. And then with request, we just charge a platform fee plus the SMS and TTS that you choose in the workflow. So I don't want to get too much into pricing. As Elaine said, if you want to talk about pricing, we're happy to entertain those discussions in a separate channel. Again, the only thing to think about here is in terms of what model you would use with Verify is, do you currently want to generate your own PIN code? Do you have your own PIN code management system? In which case that would dictate which, if you still want to use it, that would dictate what Verify model you would use. Okay, so I am very honored and very excited to pass the baton to Kitan over at Carousel, and he will talk about his Verify experience. Kitan, over to you.
All right. Hi, I'm Ketan, and specifically to say about my role is I am focusing on two things predominantly. One is increasing trust and transparency within Carousel ecosystem, which consists of user trust and security. And another one is to, you know, help merchants grow in the product and sell the product faster. So that's majorly two things I'm working on. So predominantly, we're going to talk about user trust and security today. The way this needs to be is, what this, and I don't know, let's talk about Carousel itself. I think I've missed out that. So Carousel is a classified marketplace, which helps buying and selling merely by chatting and just taking a photo and you can sell. And our motto is everyone should be able to buy and sell, at least in Southeast Asia region. And we are the fastest growing marketplace across Southeast Asia and Taiwan and Hong Kong. All right, so let's talk about some problems we had. So we had a few problems specifically in 2020, as we know, with the pandemic situation. It was a very dire time and it was an unprecedented event, and there was impact all over the nation, specifically talking about Singapore. And when COVID hit Singapore, it was a panic situation. Everybody, the goods were scarce, essential goods were scarce, specifically supermarket where shelves were empty. And the only place was online, and everybody moved towards Carousel. And there was a high need for specific essential needs. And that's where this fraudsters or scammers eat on these situations. And specifically where we saw a lot of increase in fraud, specifically in February and March last year, where there was a high demand in certain goods and we had to act on quickly, and then we had to move on with a lot of other security measures which we were facing previously. So I think those were one of the few things which we had big ones. But then fraud is, as Carousel is an open marketplace, Carousel is always risk in terms of inherent scammers and inherent sellers who are trying to fraud people. Or we also see a lot of buyer fraud where people buy things and do not pay, show fake receipts, and all those things we have seen in various amount of things, and we have to tackle it in a various specific ways. So one of the biggest way to tackle these situation was to specifically fight against fraud, specifically using 2FA and mobile verification. And specifically Vonage helped us a lot in that. And specifically in 2018, it was much higher capacity. We saw there was a immediate, as soon as we implemented, we saw an immediate 25% decline in frauds in 2018-2019. And if you see SPF reports, because as we are in user trust, we could work closely with police and all the frauds happening. We know firsthand what's happening, and we saw before implementing it was like 80% of the scams which was happening within SPF took place in Carousel. After implementing, we saw that, okay, there was a significant drop and only 44% of it was happening in 2019. And then in late 2020, we saw that, okay, it was dropped down even further to 30-35% of frauds were happening on Carousel. So this is one of the biggest lever for tackling fraud in terms of any kind of buyer or seller fraud, to make sure these happen. So the way we implemented was in two things, specifically on the fraud side. One was verifying mandatory verification for every user. So we have to, every user who want to sell something has to be verified with their phone number. So that's where the Verify API took place, which was implemented in 2018-2019. And that's where it helped us to reduce. And then recently we saw a lot of fraud increase in 2020. Then we started launching our 2FA product, specifically with the help of Verify API, where we try to detect in various different ways whether this particular user is suspicious, specifically his location, other things, device ID, and the way user is active. So we use different tools for that. Specifically, we use SIFT for detecting sort of different behavior. And based on that, we try to trigger 2FA. So if the user is, if we find it suspicious, we trigger 2FA. Also in 2020, we have a lot of moderators in the background to try to detect these kind of frauds and try to prevent them. And so we try to add these, tackle these situations by implementing 2FA. Right. Apart from that, I think that was one of the biggest help which Vonage could do to us. And I think it was much more, so we are always in the favor where our customers are happy and these frauds are stayed away from platform as much as possible. And we also don't want to introduce too much of a hindrance to the customer where it is too much of a problem, where it's too many things to add in, too many things to secure in, and then it's too much a problem for a buyer or seller to do anything on the platform. So we have to keep that balance in, but then I think it helped us quite a bit in this fashion, yeah.
And Ketan, thank you for that. And you had mentioned the use cases. I just want to touch on them really quickly because they were quite important. So you had mentioned the first one was, it sounded like new account creation. So whenever anybody's going to create a new account, they put in their phone number, they have to authenticate using OTP.
Right.
And then the second was, it sounds like Carousel has built their own fraud detection system. Correct. And that probably takes certain heuristics across the user journey and behavior, and then you would authenticate. That in itself could trigger a 2FA when warranted by your system. Okay.
That's correct.
Okay. Got it. Thank you for that. Appreciate it. Super helpful. Okay. Let's move on. Last couple of slides and message that we want to cover here is that you are all invited to early access to what we call a Verify 2.0 version of the product, which is coming out shortly. It's not out yet, but we will be releasing it as a proof of concept and then early access in the coming months. And so what Verify 2.0 is basically a new revamped API design. So before I get into the new channel, we're going to redo the API design using, this is open AI standards that should say open API standards. And that's just a fancy way of saying that you can download a YAML file and get the whole API and take a look at it. We'll also probably make it asynchronous so that you can get callbacks, so you get more view into the status of the SMS and the TTS and the other messages that are being sent within the Verify API, which is great. But the big deal here, the big kind of announcement that we're adding here is the ability to add WhatsApp as a channel for your authentication process and experience. And I understand that not all countries are going to be privy and want WhatsApp because there's maybe just not a lot of WhatsApp users in your country. We totally understand that, but I think that there are quite a few countries in Asia and Southeast Asia that do use a lot of WhatsApp. So this is coming as a channel in addition to SMS and in addition to voice. You'll still be able to choose the channel depending on what the end user experience is required. For example, you could try with WhatsApp. If the number is not associated with a WhatsApp number, then we could fall back to SMS, for example. And then eventually down the road, there's a feature within WhatsApp that allows you to quick reply to authenticate, sort of how it happens maybe with some other technology providers today, where you'll just get a prompt window that says, do you want to authenticate yes or no, as opposed to receiving a one-time password and OTP. So there's a bunch of other technical stuff that we're adding in terms of the developer experience. There's going to be this concept of applications within the API, which is just a fancy way of saying that you can customize your deployment within an application, and you'll have a lot more customized settings that you can kind of deploy each one of your deployments. I had mentioned webhooks for callbacks from the different channels, which is great, and then the authentication will be bumped up and will add not only basic auth, but we'll add JWT authentication. So we're looking forward to that. Like I said, it hasn't been released yet. We are looking for customers that are interested in trying the early versions of the product, which will, like I said, have WhatsApp and will have the new API design, Vonage applications, it will have the authentication. So if you're interested, please do sign up. I think we're going to pass along in the web chat here a link to sign up for that. It's a hyperlink here, but I think Sarah just posted it. So if you're interested in signing up and hearing more about it and possibly getting early access, please do hit that link and then enter in your details and we can go from there. Okay, so I have some reference materials here that I would be remiss if I didn't cover. So we have an entire developer team that supports our APIs and supports our customers using our APIs. So they write implementation guides and they write tutorials. We have another great case study from a good customer that's there as well. And like I said, countless other developer documentation resources that that are there. Most of it can be started, you can start mostly at probably developer.nexmo.com. Again, developer.nexmo.com, which is where you'll see the our API references. And I think that's it from me. Elaine, back over to you if you want to close us out and take us through Q&A.
Yep, sounds good. Thanks, everyone. I think it was quite insightful to hear about Verify API. I've got some questions that actually came in before the webinar even started. So they actually just plopped into a sheet. So one of the questions was, where can I use Verify and does it work in all locations?
Sure, I can take that one. So Verify works in over, let's see, I think the count is now 225 countries. So it's basically everywhere that we can send an SMS, which is quite extensive. Verify can work there. There are some exemptions. Like there are some countries where there's this type of telecom fraud that is present, and so we have to kind of limit some of those obscure countries where the telecom costs are really high. But the short answer is, major regions around the world, we can terminate both SMS and voice, and soon to be WhatsApp. And the count, if counting, is over 200 countries.
Thank you. And I think you've covered this earlier on. The question that came in was also, can I generate my own OTP? So yes, you can generate OTP if you want it. Are customers allowed to modify the 2FA template used by Verify?
Oh yeah, good question. So yes, you can. I should say two things. One, you as a customer can specify the brand without having to do any kind of further customization. So if you look at the developer documentation, there is an API parameter for brand. That's where you would put in Carousel or whatever your brand name is when using Verify to kind of customize it a little bit so that end users know that they're receiving an OTP from a trusted source. And the second thing I will add to that is right now there is the ability to customize your template. It's in our developer documentation, but there are some restrictions, but you can, yes, the short answer is yes. You can send us your custom template through an API. We'll receive it. We just want to verify that the template is in fact used for two-factor authentication. Mm-hmm. In other words, a custom template cannot be used for marketing or cannot be used for notifications. So we want to make sure that it's for two-factor authentication. At the moment it's a manual process, which we turn around fairly quickly. But you can, that's a long answer to a short question, which is you can customize the template if you desire.
All right, I got just one last question. Do we have customers who have deployed Verify that, you know, someone can speak to as a reference? I guess this is quite important because people want to know, you know, that speaking to real people and it is executed. So are there customers that, you know, they can reach out to as reference? Do we do that?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we have one customer that just told us about their experience today. We're very grateful for Carousel and Ketan for joining us. But yes, we do have references. It depends on kind of where in the world, you know, you are, so that we can align schedules because we have Verify customers. Yeah. in the North America, South America, Western Europe, and Southeast Asia and Japan. But do reach out to us if you do have interest in talking to some of our customers, and we're happy to point you to a trusted reference.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, if you know, in the event that you don't really want to reach out to us via email, we have plenty of use cases and resources for you on our website that you can refer to as well. All right, it looks like that's all the questions that we have today. I think that's all. I think we can actually have an early wrap up for this webinar. So I want to thank everyone for coming on today. And for the rest of the questions, if you have, you know, if you suddenly thought about them throughout the day, you can still drop us an email at sea.marketing@vonage.com. Also, I just want to share that we, like I said earlier, we have industry-specific use cases on Vonage Verify API on vonage.com under the resources section. However, if you would like to discuss about business use cases using our Verify API, you can also email us at sea.marketing@vonage.com. Once again, I want to thank Ketan, Sarah, and Guillermo, and our audience for joining us today. We look forward to having you at our next webinar.
Pleasure to be here. Thank you.
Thanks, Ketan. Thanks, Sarah. Thanks, Guillermo.
Bye-bye.
All right, to exit the webinar, all you have to do is just press the X button on your tab.